Hey guys, welcome to today's video. My name's Nicole. I'm a homeschooling mom to two, but a mom to three. I'm 6, 4, almost 5, and 1.5. And today I am going to be reviewing Beautiful Feet, two of their K-3. These are both new this year. We are finished with this, so it'll be kind of like a full review opinion on it. And Seasons Afield, we are halfway. It's a bit longer of a study, and yeah, I think I can give a pretty good review of it based on what we've done so far. Okay, so let's get into it. So first I'm going to show you guys a little bit about Seasons Afield and then tell you how we're liking it. So it starts out with Brambly Hedge, which is like your spine of the curriculum. Oh, and I do want to say I have a like week of lessons on my channel for Seasons Afield, and then I have a lesson like in the life, like us doing actual lessons on my channel. So you guys can check that one out as well. And box openings of the curriculum too, where I show all of the books it comes with. Okay, anyway, so Brambly Hedge, so you start out with one of their stories, and I love the illustrations. If you don't have Brambly Hedge, you gotta get it. It's so cute. Love that. Okay, so for your start of a like a topic, like autumn or things like that, there's these, and you start it out every time by reading a Brambly Hedge story. So autumn, you would read that, and then you do a week, 4 lessons. Which you can either do in a week or over 2 weeks. And then the next week, you start with another book. So this, I'm going to talk about this one, for example. So it's Preserve. And the book that you read, what I like about this curriculum is that you read the whole book out in one sitting. In the geography, you read a couple pages at a time. And when I've looked at other things, like even in like Sunlight or other of the Beautiful Feet ones, you're only reading a few pages at a time, and we like to go through like the whole story or the whole book at once. So this was the book that you read, and this is so adorable. And they talk about preserving, they talk about they moved to this new house, and let me find, it's like a root cellar that they find when they get there. And so there's all these cans and jars. And so they talk about preserving food. So then that's one lesson. So you read the book, and then it has some prompted questions that you ask. So very easy day. It says berry picking. You can go berry picking if you want. And we have like a ton of blackberries on the edge of the property, like maintained, but we have a ton. So we were able to like go and pick those. And we were able, your second lesson is to make jam, and so we were able to pick the blackberries from our property and go and make it, and it just felt really nice. If you can't tell already, this is the one that I loved. So you make that, and it's called a colloidal mixture that you're making. So they're getting a bit scientific with it, which is good because it's a science curriculum, but not too much where you're kind of like, what's going on? Or you know, I had a 4 and 6 year old, so it worked out well. And what you're doing is you're making this, and then they have a copy of this in this packet that comes with all of these different pages to watercolor, and then you put them into your Beautiful Feet notebook. So like we did the blackberries that they painted, and you do this. This is sounding like a lot, but it's like very easy to do. You do this based on this watercolor book, and it tells you all of the different steps for doing a watercolor. So lesson 1 of each week is read a book. Lesson 2 of each week is do an experiment, but they're very like easy. The jam has been the most involved. Some of them, like one that went with this book, make a compass outside with like nature. So find where east is, like find where the sun is rising, put a certain like a pine cone there, and then you know, the opposite, and find find moss and things like that to make your own compass, and then go in a certain direction and figure out what can we find this direction. Okay, what about this direction? And it was just talking about, this book is really cute too. Being able to tell where you're going. Okay, so pretty. I love so many of the books in the curriculum. So that's day two, is an experiment, some sort of activity. And then day three is watercolor with this book as a guide. And then they already have the watercolor sheets, so you're really not having to do a lot of prep there. And then day four is using this beautiful book. Slow down and wander. And you read a two-page spread. And there's so many fun different things. And then wander, so you're going on a walk with some intention. So finding the moss on the trees, or with the home in the woods one that I was showing you guys, they have, they can't afford to get everything at the store that they wanted. And so they go home and they have like a play store, and they pretend all these different things. And so for your slow down and wander, it told you to go outside and make a pretend store. And it had examples of things that the kids can do, like different ways, like to make it a little bit more work for you or to make it a little bit less, and all fun ways of doing it. So I have absolutely loved doing this. We are halfway through, and I like don't really want to end, but it's going to. I do have another video where I kind of, on my channel, where I've brainstormed our curriculum for next year, and I talk about what we are probably using for science, if you're curious. Anyway, I have just absolutely loved it. I highly recommend it. I think that mostly should hopefully answer if you guys were wondering anything about it. I have the lesson that I have on my channel. The example is not the jam one, it's the mushroom one. And that was probably our favorite book that it came with, but I couldn't find it because they look at it all the time. So that is Seasons Afield. And now I'm going to talk to you guys about their geography. And my kids are playing with their grandma in the other room. So if you hear squeaks and squeals, it's happy squeaks and squeals. So geography, I went into this. This was the first one that I bought, and I've been looking at beautiful feet for a very long time. So I did not go into this like wondering if I was going to like it. I went into this like, no matter what this is, I'm going to love it. And I probably would have if I didn't get Seasons Afield to like compare it to, because that was just amazing. So maybe if this is the only one that you used, you might just like love it and not want anything else. So I will talk to you in the same way. Okay, so this is, you don't, it's not really like a 4-day lesson, as it's not laid out as like easy to follow, I guess, as Seasons Afield, or consistent as it. I think she sees a cat. I can hear meowing and she gets very excited. Okay, so it's I can't really explain how to use it as easily as Seasons Afield, but I will show you the spines. So you have three books that you use. What you're doing is reading a few pages from each one of these books. So there's this one. I'll show you inside of them in a sec. This one and this one. This one you only really read in the beginning, but I thought it was really helpful, so I'm surprised you didn't really read more of it. Here's the Cat in the Hat one, and it has like definitions and things like that. The geography one, this is a glossary, so also has definitions, so it would tell you which one specifically to read. If they're a little bit older, they can also record it, which these were kind of long, dry explanations. My kids did not grasp from this, and I have bright children. Doesn't everyone? And then this one is what you would use for two things. So first you go to the state, and this is every time you started a new state you would read like that, and it's it has some cool information, but it was a bit overwhelming on the page. I kind of wasn't sure which parts, you know, I should read, and it was also a little bit dry, but, and it's supposed to be this like family trip, So that's what it is you're following this family as they go, but you aren't doing it in the order that they actually went. So to read like what the kids are saying, you know, like, dear grandma, you're not following the trip. So it didn't really work out that well. And then the other way that you're using it is this is how you would color in your state pretty much every time. You would just pull out this map and find the state on here and then write it on there and then color in the state. And I don't think it was very easy to grasp for them. And then I pulled out one of the books that was my favorite. I think this was Arizona, New Mexico. So it's New Mexico, but then you're also doing like the states around it, even though you're not really learning about the states around it. Obviously, you're not going to have 50 books, but I thought this was one of the better examples because it really talks about the landscape and things like that. So essentially, it just didn't really have many activities to do. It wasn't very interactive like I was expecting. I thought almost every lesson would have at least like a cooking idea. But I would say 80 to 90% were videos to watch, and we're kind of a screen-free family for the most part. So having them, it just kind of like, I don't want to incorporate that into our day. I did it a few times because I just didn't have the knowledge to give to them. Like it was all kind of coming from me. It felt like the book didn't really give me a lot. This book didn't really give me a lot to go off of. And then another thing they're supposed to do every time they did a new state was this. So my 6-year-old really likes doing crosswords. My 4-year-old could do it, but he's not like reading words like this. So he would just kind of try and match the letters, which was kind of tricky for him, but it's the exact same thing. You can see that they didn't do hardly any of these. It's the exact same thing for every state. And just kind of boring. I thought this was going to be a lot more exciting to kind of like pull the state together, and I just don't really think they like maintain many of the concepts. So hopefully that kind of helps you get an idea of both of these. If you have any questions, please leave them down below. I'm trying to think of if there's anything else that you guys might be wondering before you enter into it. I have much preferred the read alouds from Seasons of Field as well. The geography, it didn't have any that we wanted to keep out, and like that they were like, oh, can I please read this with Dad before bed tonight? But Seasons of Field, almost every single book is like up in their room or in with our bookshelf upstairs because they've taken it up there and are enjoying it. So has this turned me on or off to Beautiful Feet? I am doing one of theirs next year for very likely. I'm kind of debating between Beautiful Feet, Around the World with Picture Books 2, and which I talk about in my brainstorm video, but debating between that and, I didn't mention this actually, Sunlight, the HBL, History, Bible, Literature, because that also looks very good. Same sort of premise, but I don't think that it's going to have as many activities as the Around the World, which looks like it's going to be a lot better than the geography. So maybe it's also because history is just more interesting than geography, kind of hard to make that. I don't know. I think we could have done more activities. The very first one, the very beginning of it, it says to like get kinetic sand and make like the mountains and make different things, make a map with the kinetic sand. And I was like, this is going to be great. Like, that sounds really fun. That's our kind of thing. And I don't have to think of it. It's already there for me. I'm like, oh yeah, great idea. Let's do that. And that was, I think, the only one like that. And then otherwise, like I said, it was cooking ideas, which I was good with. I was expecting that, but I don't think there were any other activities, not even go outside. Okay, so that's it. So, yes. So ultimately, that's how I feel about these two. Let me know if you guys have tried these, what you thought of them. But anyway, I'm excited to try out their other one. It'll be kind of like a, see how they like it. I am kind of debating early American history too. just to kind of do this year. But I think I'm going to just piece together some books on my own. Anyway, I'm starting to ramble. Okay, thank you guys for watching. Go check out my other videos, especially the where I do the lessons in the life and the unboxing of these ones. So you guys can check all of it out. All right, thanks, guys.